First at noon, a man hit and killed by a DeLand police officer this morning. FHP now tells us Volusia County deputies tried to pull over a car after midnight, but the driver just wouldn't stop. Good afternoon and thanks for joining us. I'm Meredith McDonough.
And I'm Jason Guy. We now know deputies were chasing Marlon Brown. WESH 2's Claire Metz is live in DeLand. And Claire, why were officials chasing him?
Well, we're actually at the scene where 38-year-old Marlon Brown was hit and killed by the DeLand police officer. But let me first explain, Jason, that according to the Florida Highway Patrol, the sheriff's deputy wasn't technically chasing Mr. Brown. We have a picture of the 38-year-old suspect because although he's got an address in Sanford, he has a long criminal history here in the Volusia County area. Matter of fact, his license has not only been suspended, it's literally been canceled because of a number of driving infractions previously. According to the Florida Highway Patrol, a Volusia County Sheriff's deputy had noticed Mr. Brown driving without a seatbelt. So the deputy got behind Brown, who was in a vehicle with four other people. But Brown didn't stop. Brown didn't speed away from the deputy, but he refused to stop, so the deputy backed off. However, he put an alert out about the vehicle, and 2 minutes later, DeLand police got behind the vehicle. They followed him down this dead-end road at where the vehicle driven by Mr. Brown came to a stop. Mr. Brown jumped out of the vehicle and took off. One of the DeLand police officers was behind the suspect vehicle. Another DeLand police officer, Officer James Harris, came up around that vehicle and tapped the victim with his right, hitting him, and then ultimately ran over the suspect, Mr. Marlon Brown. Now, the suspect vehicle was away from the scene. Mr. Brown had actually run from the vehicle, so he was beneath the DeLand police officer's car, and literally they had to lift the car off him where he was pronounced dead. Now, Florida Highway Patrol tell us they are investigating this from all aspects. They don't know where Mr. Brown had been coming from or where he was going to. They're talking to four other women who were in the vehicle with him. The vehicle did not belong to Mr. Brown. It belonged to a friend of his. But again, he shouldn't have been driving. His license had been canceled. He has he also just recently got out of jail for uttering a forged instrument, writing a check that didn't belong to him. And he's got a history of some drug charges here in the Volusia County area. But that may or may not have anything to do with this investigation. FHP says they are looking to see whether or not the officer involved did anything wrong when he came after Mr. Brown here and drove around a second DeLand police officer, hitting and killing the man. That officer is a fairly new hire for DeLand Police. He was just hired in August of this past year, a recent graduate of the police academy, so he doesn't actually even have a record with DeLand Police yet. We understand he is on administrative leave while FHP investigates. There is dash cam video from DeLand officers. They're working to get that and get radio transmissions that occurred between the Volusia County Sheriff's deputy who first spotted this vehicle and the DeLand police officers who finished over here at this scene. So we'll get more information and we'll bring it to you a little later on WESH 2 News. Reporting live in DeLand, Volusia County, Claire Metz, WESH 2 News.